Good morning. It's Thursday, March 27, 2020. It's day 11, and I just wanted to talk about imperfections today. There's so many ways that we see ourselves that we wanted to be perfect, like being a perfect parent, being a perfect wife or husband, friend. Anything we could think of, we are trying to do our best to be perfect. As most of us know, there is no such thing as being perfect, because even if you have reached a level of perfection, you'll still see new things that are still not good enough. And so there's a point where we just have to say, okay, I did my best. Everything I did so far is to the fullest that I can. And just this morning, I personally experienced some of those moments. It's like, oh, I wanted to be a nice morning. Everything started very well. And then one thing after the other, it fell apart. And the idea is to just let go of feeling to have to be perfect, and to think that unless something doesn't go right way, that it's not good enough. So today I just want to bring across different ways of how we can be okay with imperfections. So there's a friend of ours that we just had some conversations this morning through text about, you know, being in the health field, and that, you know, there she's trying to do everything that she can and feels that because you're doing a lot on one side, you're lacking, you know, at home because you're not home. And so it's just, again, it goes hand in hand with self-compassion that I talked about the other day, and actually yesterday. And so it kind of brings it together to understand that we might have been growing up with having to be perfect in a way, right? So our parents might have asked us to do great in school, so we then understood that unless I'm getting an A or 6 in Switzerland or a 1 in Germany, then you're not good enough. And so that is not necessarily the truth. It's just what we understood it to be, or the comprehension was that it should be. And that's how we became part of us, how we started to think that unless I'm giving my everything and all and it's coming out as perfect, I completed my task. But that's not what it is. So we all have our flaws. We are born with them. I just had a conversation with a friend yesterday about this. And it is something that we have to come to be okay with, that whatever we do, we're giving our best, we do the best that we can, and to just say it's okay if something doesn't go well. And so my appeal today, or just to ask you, is just to give yourself a break, just to maybe take a step back. And let's say if you are a perfectionist who likes to have everything done and right and clean, or whatever the perfection in you is looking at, it's to just take a step back and maybe consolidate things. Like, for instance, once somebody said, like, if you have dishes to do, like, if you always wanted to do them right away, how would you collect them and then do a bunch of them in a little bit? And so it's kind of like letting go and be okay with that feeling of like, oh, I want to do it, but I shouldn't, and things like this. So it really is something to just observe. Again, all these things I'm talking to you about is raising your awareness to what you've been doing. Have you been doing it? If you haven't, how can you change it? Or if you don't want to change it, how would that be affecting me? And it's kind of like just being more open-minded. I'm watching a lot of the I'm part of many mindful summits, and all these talks, all it is about awareness, about open heart, kindness, compassion. So it's kind of really getting more vulnerable with ourselves and our surroundings, especially in the times we are in right now. It is the perfect time to reflect, to better understand where we're coming from, so that once it's over and done with, we can really get the most out of it. And so here we are. Imperfections are welcome, and that's who we are. All right, have a great day. Take care.